Treefort Music Fest is an annual celebration of the arts, full of magic, revelry, and intrigue. Tonight, we flip this merry monster on its back and take a look at its dark underbelly. This is Fort Files.
A lot goes into everything that is Treefort, from the wristbands to security, food to beverage, lighting to those one things that make the guitars go, oh, wow, 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 wow. But attendees of Treefort 2015 witnessed a rare hiccup on the front page of the trail guide, a glaring omission. The F had vanished.
Listen, here it is right here. Yeah, you're gonna be going on at 8 o'clock.
Comedy Fort, you old so-and-so, how are ya?
Treefort's copy editor had the painstaking task of making sure every word in every bit of literature was free from grammatical error or spelling error.
Okay, that looks great.
That's my mouse.
I take a lot of care with these things. I do. I swear the trail guide was squeaky clean when I put it to bed.
We're done.
Holy man, holy guacamole.
I love Tree Fort. I don't love Tree Ort.
Tree Ort, Tree Ort, Tree Ort, Tree
Ort,
Tree Ort,
Tree Ort. Where the F is Tree Ort. It's funny because there is no F in funny when this happens to you.
Many theories abound as to exactly what happened. Was it a simple spelling error? Or was foul play afoot?
You know, every year at Hackfort, we enlist forensic teams to try to figure out what really happened. And do you want to know what I think? I think it was an inside job.
Grew up on that rap a lot. Grew up on that native son. Beats be like I trap a lot. Rhyme like all I say to son.
Mm-hmm. It is still inconclusive exactly what happened that year, except that the Tree Ork Trail Guide is now a collector's item amongst many fans. The iconic Treefort symbol can be seen adorning a plethora of venues all over downtown Boise. Festival volunteers such as Gloria Murphy know them well.
Made it. How are you?
It's good to see you.
According to those close to her, Miss Murphy is a serious music fan.
One time, I showed up at Gloria's apartment and she was listening to records. I remember so clearly she said, "I love this song." Then she turned it up, way up. And I thought, wow, that's someone who really likes music.
Yes, it was my first time working as a volunteer. Everyone I knew who had done it had a great experience, so I was really looking forward to it.
Gloria quickly found herself immersed in all that Treefort has to offer.
I woke up early, went to Yoga Fort, listened to a reading at Story Fort.
I remember texting Gloria, and I asked her, are things wonderful? And she said, yes. They were wonderful.
At the end of the second day, Miss Murphy was checking wristbands at the linen building. A peculiar energy was in the air. Perhaps it was due to Alefort having not yet kicked off, leaving a disappointingly normal number of beer options. Perhaps the poutine food truck had run out of vegan gravy. Or perhaps it was something else.
I peered into the venue and I noticed a crowd of people standing underneath the Treefort flag, only the flag was gone. I ran in, looking for any sign of the culprit. I saw a guy near the bathrooms. For sure, I was gonna catch him. I mean, he was wearing a leather jacket, bolo tie, and a wide-brimmed hat. So I went after him.
You've been to the food court yet?
I got another text from Gloria. Things aren't wonderful anymore.
Weeks later, the flag was discovered. However, the perp is still on the run.
Next week on Fort Files. The mystery of who scheduled my favorite bands at the same time at opposite ends of town. If you have any information regarding these mysteries, please contact Treefort Music Fest. Or come experience them yourself. March 21st through the 25th, 2018, Boise, Idaho.